Hello everyone and welcome back to the Hammered Corner. In today's video, we will be looking at why coins were historically countermarked or counterstamped. But just before we get into it, be sure to leave a like on the video and subscribe with that notification bell turned on so you never miss a video here on the channel. A countermarked, punchmarked or counterstamped coin is a coin that has had some additional mark or symbol punched onto it at some point after it was originally produced while in circulation. But this practice is now obsolete. Countermarking can be done for a variety of reasons. If the currency is reformed, existing coins may be rendered void. In this situation, coins already in circulation could be marked with a new value, according to the new currency system. The lifespan of existing coins could thus be extended, which might under some circumstances be a cheaper alternative to recalling the coins, melting them, and striking replacements. Similarly, foreign coins could be marked as legal or accepted currency, thus allowing them to circulate in the area where they were countermarked. It was a very common practice to see coins with countermarks during the 18th century, as many people were illiterate and could not tell that coins they had were real or whether they were a forgery. So this would have been a good practice to weed out those that were not authentic, by rendering them void with a counterstamp. At this time, many countries across the world relied on necessity money from other countries for everyday transactions. One of the major places that required such help were the countries in the Caribbean. The islands were valuable stopping points in the sea journey between South America and Europe, and the nations in conflict in Europe brought their conflicts to the islands. Each of the island groups at one time or another during the 17th, 18th and into the 19th century used necessity money often in the form of cut and countermarked versions of silver, gold and other metallic coins of whichever major nation controlled a particular island at that particular time. While most of the cut pieces originated as Spanish colonial or English coins, examples of cut Massachusetts silver coinage used in island circulation in the late 17th century are known. So although it was very common to ship out and countermark worn English coinage, it was a common sight to see foreign countermarked coins circulate in the late 18th century under George III. There was a huge silver shortage during his reign, where they were forced to issue copper tokens for everyday purchases among vendors, with a very common foreign coin countermarked being used known as the Spanish 8 reals. The host coin would be stamped with a small portrait of George III, rendering that particular piece regal tender in the United Kingdom. These are very sought after coins and a must have for any George III collectors out there. But be careful, their high demand also brings many fakes. So do your research and ask if you're not 100% sure. This very worn Queen Anne shilling was a coin I once had in my collection and featured in a video a few months ago. It has a small cross stamped onto the bust, and as of yet, I am unable to find an exact match to that countermark, so have never been able to say for certain its purpose of doing so. Maybe it was so worn it was marked to display its value, or could it have circulated in the Caribbean, and somehow find its way back to England? These are all types of questions that keeps me so intrigued in this hobby, and I hope by watching this video, has made you see another side of numismatics that you could see yourself getting into. So thank you all for your continued support, and as always, keep collecting.